Hello everyone, today I would be sharing a video how I managed a case of Morgagnian cataract which had a small capsular dehiscence in the inferior part. As we all know that Morgagnian cataract is a kind of hypermature cataract in which the total liquefaction of cortex which allow the nucleus to sink inferiorly. Since the cataract is hypermature and there is no glow, so always stain the capsule with a torn blue. Fill the chamber with high viscosity cohesive viscoelastic. Prepare your second side port in incision. Whenever I deal with any kind of hypermature cataract, whether it's a Morgagnian cataract or intermission cataract, I always make my main port incision before starting my capsular access. As I made a small nick in the intercapsule, you can see that milky fluid came out from the lens. This is the time where you can assess the strength of capsular bag also. Since all cortical matter has become liquid, therefore the nucleus has become free and started rotating freely in the bag. It is a fact that suspensory ligaments, capsular ligaments become weaker in the hypermature cataracts. So you have to be very cautious and your all maneuvers must be gentle and controlled. Performing phaco and nucleus segmentation is a challenge in such cases because the nucleus start rotating freely and it's very difficult to hold the nucleus. Here I always try to catch the nucleus with the phaco tip while my second instrument, which is Sensky hook, supports the nucleus and it prevents the rotation. For me, the vertical chopping is the most trusted technique of phaco fragmentation in such cases. Always try to maintain the nucleus bulk. Do not start eating the pieces and always try to hold the nucleus at places and try to divide it smaller pieces. This is the time where you need to maintain your patience, rotate the nucleus in different areas, hold the nucleus and try to do chopping, and you can divide the nucleus in small fragments. And if you are sure that you have divided the nucleus in smaller pieces, then you can bring a small piece at the level of iris plane and you can finish your fragmentation at that level. Rotate the nucleus, make sure it is free. If it is not free, then chop it and then bring it at the level of iris plane and you can finish your phaco fragmentation. This patient was having a capsular weakness in the inferior part, so therefore I have reduced the intraocular pressure of surgery. You can see it is reduced to 40 mm of mercury. If you are using gravity fed system, then you can reduce the bottle height and you can do safe phaco fragmentation. So I was very happy. I finished my phaco fragmentation without any problem or without any extension of capsular dehiscence. I filled the chamber with viscoelastic. I always prefer cohesive viscoelastic during IOL implantation. So tip for the Morgagnian cataract is, which I learned from my experience, is always maintain the nucleus bulk. You divide the nucleus in several pieces and then if you are sure that your nucleus has sufficient smaller pieces, then start doing the phaco fragmentation. Thanks for watching.